What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're taking a look at the new Forza Motorsport here on the Steam Deck, which unfortunately at time of making this video doesn't run on SteamOS other than cloud gaming with GeForce NOW or Xbox cloud gaming, Game Pass. So that's kind of what I want to focus on, is the different ways to play this game with your Game Pass subscription, or if you have Windows on your Steam Deck, you can play it locally there with Steam or Xbox Game Pass. So we'll take a look at that here, starting with SteamOS, which, like I said, unfortunately isn't running on there. So we're using GeForce NOW. I'll have the 4080 tier running here from them. They have a free tier, the priority, and the 4080. And then, of course, Xbox Cloud Gaming here, which is part of your Xbox Game Pass Ultimate subscription. So I'll go ahead and start here with Xbox Cloud Gaming, which offers a 1080p 60fps experience. It's a stream and the game, as far as I know. As far as settings for this one, we'll get into that, but let's go ahead and scroll down here using our controller. We'll launch into the game, which usually only takes a few seconds. I'll speed us past that. As far as the settings, we don't have access to the Xbox Series X's performance RT mode, but we do have performance and visual mode, and visual being the 30fps, which in cloud gaming I really don't recommend. So we stick with the performance mode for 60fps. And we get into the gameplay, and typical for Xbox, it's not necessarily the cleanest picture for 1080p 60. There is some pixelation and low bitrate and that type of thing, but I will say, in the past few months, or really even the past 6 months to a year, input latency for me has gotten pretty good on Xbox Cloud Gaming, even if the picture quality isn't always where I want it to be. And that does carry over here to Forza Motorsport, even on the Steam Deck, which 1080p is going to give you those bars when you're playing on Steam Deck at the top and bottom. They don't have a 1610 ratio like GeForce NOW, which we'll get into, but the picture quality still looks pretty good because it's such a small screen, you don't notice the bitrate and pixelation as much. If you're watching this video on a larger screen, you'll see the quality differences that I'm talking about more, and you might even be familiar already with Xbox Cloud Gaming. But for me, input latency is fine. I didn't have any stutters or issues or real drops in frame rate. It's just that sometimes the picture quality isn't quite where I want it, but again, on the deck screen, it's really not too bad and offers a great way to play the game if you already have Xbox Cloud Gaming. I have a video on the channel already how to set up Cloud Gaming, GeForce NOW, Xbox Cloud Gaming, and all of that. So I'll put links to those in the description if you need any guides on how to install and play Xbox Cloud Gaming or GeForce NOW on SteamOS for your Steam Deck. Now let's move over and take a look at GeForce NOW, which, like I said, I'll be on my 4080 tier subscription here. This gives us more options because with Xbox Cloud Gaming, we can't change bitrate or anything like that or resolution. With GFN, we can here. We have control of our bitrate. We can even do 1280 by 800 at 1610, which is perfect in handheld mode. No bars at the top or bottom. It runs really great, especially if you're on the 4080. But again, they have a free tier and priority tier as well. But since I'm docked here, I'm just going to go ahead and choose 1080p. You can use whatever you want for bitrate that works for you, depending on your Wi-Fi or your connection. I can usually get away with 25 to 45, depending on what I'm doing. If you get a lot of frame drops or skips or issues, you can just start dropping that down until that kind of goes away. Now, like I said, you have Steam. So if you bought the game, you can do it here. Or if you have Xbox Game Pass, you can use that version as well. So for me, I'll do Xbox. I'll add that to my library. And then I can click play, and that'll get us launched into the game. So that'll be my Game Pass version, which is, of course, my same save that I have with my Xbox and Xbox Cloud Gaming and all of that combined. We'll get loaded in here. We do have to log into our Xbox account, and then once we do that, we'll be in. Now, of course, we also get the full suite of PC settings this way. I'll be at 1080p, full screen. I'm not using any DLSS or anything here, and mostly using Ultra. It'll default to like auto everything. You can go through and change all these however you want. But depending on what tier you're on with GFN, it'll depend on what settings you want to go with. But running the game this way, of course, 1080p picture quality for GeForce NOW is way better than Xbox Cloud Gaming, and so is input latency. Even though Xbox has gotten pretty good, GeForce NOW, especially the 4080 tier, is just unmatched when it comes to input latency, and that includes Steam Deck on Wi-Fi. So I know not everyone's real keen on cloud gaming, and it certainly has had its rough and bad times, but when it comes to cloud gaming, GeForce NOW definitely offers the best experience out there, especially if you can splurge for that ultimate tier. Input latency, even on devices like this, can be darn near local. It is really good. Switching into other modes like nighttime and everything, again, it looks really clean. Not like on Xbox where we might get more banding and pixelation and stuff like that. It looks really good. I held a pretty stable 60 FPS even on the browser here. And again, I can put links in the description for how to install GeForce NOW and use that on your deck as well. All right, let's move over and take a look at Windows, because that's going to be another way to run Forza Motorsport here. All right, over here on Windows, we can use our Xbox app. Now, you could do cloud gaming here as well, Xbox Cloud Gaming, GeForce Now. They're super easy to set up, of course, no workarounds like over on SteamOS, and it works great. But I'm going to focus on the local here because I think that's what people would want to try. I do get the warning that I need updated drivers and all of that. And that's the other thing. We are running on March drivers here, unfortunately, from Valve for Windows. I really wish we would get an update to that. So if they do get this working on SteamOS, I would expect that we might even get better performance over there. But at 720p, pretty much low everything here in FSR on, we can jump in here and get ourselves basically a 30 FPS experience, which I was really surprised. Now, I can run a game over 30 as well, but I kind of let it cap this here and keep it at 30. I do get the occasional dip under 30, 27 or 29. But typically, whatever race I was in or whatever track, it recovered from that pretty quickly and got me back to 30. I could flatten out those frame times with using my RTSS global 30 FPS cap or something like that, more VSync, and that could get cleaned up even better. But I wanted to leave that off for the video just to see what performance was doing. And it was actually pretty good. This was very playable for a fairly stable 30 FPS experience here on Windows for the Steam Deck. Now, I wanted to try a different track. I had some rain weather effects. I slowed down, let some more cars get in front of me, so the system's working a little bit harder. And I saw that 27, 29 dip that I get from time to time, but it did recover. And for basically the rest of the match or the race, I was able to get that 30 FPS again. So you could play this locally on Windows on your Steam Deck, at least from what I'm seeing here, with pretty much as low a settings as you can get using some FSR and maybe capping to 30. And cleaning things up, but all in all, pretty playable experience. So when you're using Game Pass on your Steam Deck, whether you're SteamOS or Windows, there are ways to get in and play something like Forza Motorsport here. Hopefully they will get the game working natively on SteamOS and we can try it there, but as of right now anyways, that's not working. All right guys, thanks a lot for coming to check out the video. As always, I really appreciate it. I'll see you in the next one.